The NHL reminds us that some people will always be immature. Let's be honest, is it really cool for guys in their 20s and 30s to drop the gloves and start fights? It does sound rather silly, doesn't it? But that doesn't matter. NHL fans absolutely love fights. Though there is the great debate as to whether or not it should be allowed in hockey, it seems as though fans get louder for hockey fights than when their team scores. Well, we'll let you decide on these ones. I'm Daquan Young, and here are the 10 craziest NHL brawls ever. Number 10. The Vancouver Canucks, Chicago Blackhawks, 2009. From 2009 to 2013, no rivalry in NHL was more entertaining than the Blackhawks-Canucks. Besides meeting in the playoffs 3 years in a row, from 2009 to 2011, there were a bunch of personal rivalries. Andrew Ladd and Ryan Kessler butted heads, Roberto Luongo hated Dustin Byfuglien, Duncan Keith hated Alex Burrows, the Sedins and Dave Bolin got into it as well. But maybe the most heated moment of their rivalry was this March 29, 2009 brawl. After Byfuglien bolted over Luongo, tempers flared.
Conversation has continued as now O'Brien, who's one of their top guys now, Eager's gonna drop the glove. Eager and Bieksa. And a couple of others have paired off. Seabrook, oh, and Eager, a big left hand cutter. That's Mike Hassenfratz. There's Duncan Keith along with Burrows. And they have just about all paired up. Burrows seemed to have a head full of hair.
And yes, that was Burrows grabbing Keith's hair. What a rivalry. Number 9, the Pittsburgh Penguins, Philadelphia Flyers in 2012. The Battle of Pennsylvania has always been entertaining, but 4 decades of going at each other's throats finally reached a breaking point. In the 2012 meeting, Joe Vitale of the Penguins gave a big open ice hit to Danny Briere of the Flyers. It then brought a full-out brawl between both teams.
It's with all the injuries and the big hit there, Vitale and Briere. Look out.
Yeah, look out is right. He's ready too. Oh man, Shane's getting it.
And I think what Peter Laviolette is upset about in a 6-3 hot.
As destiny would have it, these two teams would meet in the playoffs the same year, with Philly exacting revenge on the hit by sending home Pittsburgh in 6 games. Number 8, Vancouver Canucks, Calgary Flames, 2014. These two Pacific Division rivals really hate each other, and it couldn't have been more evident when they fought right at puck drop in a January 2014 clash.
At the Vancouver bench is already looking at the here we Calgary go. Bench.
Line brawl to start this game. Westgarth and Bieksa are separated. Sestito and McGrattan back at the blue line. Torts is angry.
Is he ever here?
What became so infamous about this incident was when Canucks head coach John Tortorella burst into the Flames dressing room to yell at the team for starting their tough guys to match up with his stars. Torts was suspended for 15 games, and it became his most memorable moment as Canucks head coach. Number 7, Montreal Canadiens, Boston Bruins, 2011. There's probably no better rivalry in hockey than the Canadiens and Bruins, two original six franchises who have met in the playoffs 6 times since 2002. After Milan Lucic bulled over Carey Price and a series of ugly hits took place, tempers flared.
He's not in a position to control that rebound, and Lucic buries it.
Marchand unloads. Now we got a Donnybrook going.
Price then faced off against Boston Bruins goalie Tim Thomas.
Here we go. Price goes for the right, Thomas goes for the takedown.
Luckily for us fans, these teams will face off in the playoffs with Boston beating Montreal in 7 games. Number 6, New York Islanders, Pittsburgh Penguins, 2011. After a pair of Penguins players laid out some rather controversial hits on the Isles players, that was enough. The longtime Atlantic Division rivals never had respect for each other, and this was built up for a long time.
Here we go.
Yep, fight number 1 of the night. And it is Haley. Now Adams basically said, okay, you want to start trouble? I'll finish it for you.
That was only the start. And there had been another fight just minutes later between Eric Goddard of Pittsburgh and the Islanders' Trevor Gillies.
Here's another scrap. Goddard.
Eric Goddard.
Trevor Gillies.
Yep. Trevor Gillies.
In the second period, things got even messier after Matt Martin attacked Max Talbot from Pittsburgh.
Somebody went after somebody at center ice. Talbot's down, and Martin went after him. And this is in response
to the hit on Blake Como.
Yes, and he went right after him. I don't know if he hit him or not, but when I looked down, Talbot was in a ball protecting himself as Matt Martin. Now we got another fight going on. Dupuis.
we weren't done there either.
Right now,
and he's going to go over and maybe try to, he's getting escorted to the penalty box.
A round of applause for the players and referees who managed to settle all of this.
Number 5,
the Anaheim Ducks, Los Angeles Kings. They've combined for 3 Stanley Cups and are the classes of California's NHL teams. With tensions always high and these two standing in each other's way, it's no shock Corey Perry of Anaheim snapped and sparked a huge fight.
It's Kyle Clifford, whose job it is to try and get.
One innocent shove doesn't usually start an all-out fight, but it did here. It's better than any WWE Royal Rumble you've ever watched.
Kevin Bieksa and McKinn, Andy Andoroff are all involved in what is now a full-on line brawl. And you can see the referees standing off to the side of it, just watching. Take down, get back up, and keep throwing.
How about Rickard Rakell? I don't know he's been in a fight before, John.
Not at the...
Number 4, Vancouver Canucks, Boston Bruins, 2012. Holy smokes, the Canucks love brawls. Their January 2012 showdown against the Boston Bruins was the first meeting between these clubs since the Bees won Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final in a heated, emotional series. This was a revenge game for the Canucks, and the brawl was just insane. Sean Thornton went after Alex Burrows, and everything broke loose.
Little tap, IA, and here comes Thornton as Alex had the stick.
It had the feel of a playoff game. Just watch as these two teams, who play each other twice a year, fight like they face off every day.
For bench, I didn't see how it started.
Now the Canucks en masse, and here comes the Bruins.
And Lucic, Thornton in the middle of things. Weiss has squared off in the Vancouver zone. He's in a full skate.
Nathan Horton and Dale Weiss got into it too, capping off one epic brawl.
Well, this is hard to pick which one you're going to watch.
Number 3, Vancouver Canucks, Colorado Avalanche, 2004. This was a tragic incident that we wish never took place. Here's the storyline. Vancouver Canucks captain Marcus Naslund received an ugly headshot from the Colorado Avalanche's Steve Moore. Moore didn't get suspended, and when these teams wound up meeting later in the season, Canucks tough guy Ty Bertuzzi sucker punched Moore in the back of the head. What followed was an all-out brawl.
Right after the Avalanche player, and here we go. It is 5-on-5, and now the goalie Hedman wants Abisher. He's calling Abisher, and he's out.
And somebody's hurt badly. Well, congratulations to whatever's going on. And now they just got...
Bertuzzi was suspended for the rest of the season, and Moore would never play hockey again due to the severe neck injuries he suffered. Number 2, Ottawa Senators, Philadelphia Flyers, 2004. There's a reason why the Flyers have been known as the Broad Street Bullies for decades. Ottawa Senators enforcer Rob Ray had enough of Donald Brashear's bullying and took a stand.
In the first place, and now Brashear trying to yank his jersey off. Ray trying to get a hand free, falls, gets back up. And now Ray trying to come over the top of the right hand of his own.
That didn't stop the other members of each team from fighting.
Look out here. And Simpson just went in after Brashear, and now he's pounding away. Anybody can get a hold of him. Here goes Patty Lalime.
Ash comes in, so Lalime.
Even the goalies got in on the action.
Go.
Well, Ash won't take the mask off. Lalime does it for him. Lalime gets the sweater over top of the head of Ash, but he falls.
The video will suggest otherwise, but these two teams don't even have a heated history. It's not like the Yankees and Red Sox or anything. Number 1, the brawl in Hockey Town, 1997. The Colorado Avalanche and Detroit Red Wings were the NHL's two most dominant squads in the 90s and early 2000s, combining for 5 Stanley Cups from 1996 to 2002, and they met in the playoffs 5 times during that span. The blood was boiling for a while between these two teams after Claude Lemieux broke Chris Draper's jaw and gave him a concussion with this hit in 1996.
Coffey banged it back the other way to Draper, waiting for his teammates to clear. Draper's hurt. He got leveled.
Darren McCarty got his revenge by crushing Lemieux, which started the infamous brawl in Hockey Town.
That we see Igor Larionov go, but he did, and now Darren McCarty gets his shots in at Claude Lemieux.
By Aaron Ward back in Denver. Look out, here we go. Monty drops him. Oh, Lovren's a tough kid, boy, out of Florida. The pusher's certainly in it. up to his neck with this guy. And he's a veteran, knows how to fight.
Goalies Patrick Waugh and Mike Vernon stole the spotlight.
Vernon and Waugh! Mike Vernon with a great left, follows up with the right.
To quote NHL announcer John Forslin, that's hockey, baby. What's your favorite NHL brawl ever? Join us in the comments below. If you like this video and learned a thing or two, clicking the like button helps us out a ton and we really appreciate it. If this is your first time coming around to Total Pro Sports though, subscribing is a great idea because we put out videos like this every single day. But as always, thanks for watching and we'll see you guys next time.